We're going to make moxa cloth. This is used with pressing moxa, so it's a kind of special thing that most people don't know about pressing moxa, and even when they do, they don't know about pre-treating your moxa cloth with herbs. So you can make moxa cloth with all kinds of different formulas. Today, I decided I have a long time ago, I ground up a bunch of Dúhuó jìshēng tāng. Originally, this formula was, even though it's a tāng, it was made as a coarse powder and then the powder was boiled. And so I made a bunch and I just thought, oh, that would be good, you know, if you're using moxa for bee patterns, cold and damp and pain and maybe somewhat deficient. So I've measured out about 45 grams of this Dúhuó jìshēng tāng, and I'm going to put them in the Okay, I'm going to put them in the jar. Good thing this is not for internal use because, yeah, cat's on the table. Okay, so I've got my 45 grams of herbs approximately, and then you can use, you need a liquid. So you could use water, you could actually make it into a decoction. You could, excuse me, we're back. You could make it into a decoction. You could just soak it in water, you know, hot water for a period of time. You could use alcohol, like, you know, vodka or something, or you can use vinegar, depending on the formula and what you're trying to do with it. Of course, vinegar is good for the sinews and, you know, does treat pain. And so I'm gonna, in this case, use vinegar as my liquid. I'm gonna use 20, 250 milliliters. Of course, anytime they say vinegar in a Chinese medicine recipe, it means rice vinegar. That's 250. Okay. So you just pour it in. And I'm going to give it a stir. And then I'm going to agitate it maybe a couple times a day and let it sit for probably 2 days because I have a day off in 2 days and I can finish working on this. And by then, the vinegar hopefully will have absorbed a good portion of the herbs. The other thing that you need is the cloth. So this is some moxa cloth that I made before with a different recipe. It has honghua in it, and so it ends up making the cloth very yellow. I don't know if you can see. Here's some white cloth. Yeah, you can definitely see the difference. And so, you know, the recipe will have a different appearance depending on what herbs you use. These strips are just unbleached 100% cotton muslin, which is, you know, just really the ch cheapest cloth you can get. I do like unbleached. And so you do want cotton because you want it to absorb. If it's some kind of synthetic, it's not going to absorb the herbs. And you want to tear it into strips. So actually, I wanted to show you tearing it into strips, but my cat is lying on top of the other bit of cloth, so I may have to do that in a minute. These strips are twice as long as you need it because when we soak them and hang them to dry, it's easier to hang this many and then cut them in half later rather than if you cut them in half first, then you just have to handle more strips of cloth when you're soaking them and hanging them to dry. If you are not familiar with working with cloth, let's see, what do we have here? Basically, you know, you could make it neater, but this is like disposable and you don't want to spend a lot of time and effort with each thing. And so generally I measure into 2-inch strips. I'm not measuring right now, but let's say that's 2 inches. I mark it with a pencil and then I just make a tiny little cut. Maybe you can see. And once you have the cut, you can just rip it apart. So then that's how I make the strips. It's easier than trying to cut them. And plus, I'm a messy person, so I don't mind the mess. Often there's some little threads that are left dangling, so you can cut those off. And so basically, then this strip of cloth, after it's soaked in the herbs and dried, this is short enough to be one strip rather than my other ones here were the length for 2 strips, but that's the cloth I have right now. So then you would fold it into, you know, on top of itself, so you have a certain thickness to it. And we're going to use this in pressing moxa, which I'll show you later. Okay, so I'll be back when the herbs have, when the vinegar has absorbed the herbs and we're ready for the next step. Let's strain this now. It's 2 days later. Vinegar smell. Okay, it's time to do the work. Here's the liquid. We're going to just put the cloth strips in. They don't absorb as quickly as you might think, so you have to be a little patient. Even though the cloth has been pre-washed, it still takes a while to absorb. When you unfold it, you find all these areas where the liquid hasn't reached. It's surprising how long it takes. So while I'm working with those that have absorbed it, I'm going to let others start absorbing. Oops, I just spilled. So I want to not waste any. I want to keep as much as I can. And so I want to squeeze it out. There are various ways of doing it, but this works. It would probably work better if I had more in it, so I'll leave it here for a minute. Okay, the moxa cloth has sat for a couple of days to dry. So now we can just take it and fold the pieces. And when we use it, we'll fold it one more time like that. but I'm only going to fold it halfway for now. I have some longer strips. They all would have been longer strips if I didn't have a small piece to work with, but we can cut these longer strips in half. And any threads that are clinging to it, you can cut off and throw away. Okay, so I'm just gonna cut and fold these, and then I'll have my moxa cloth. There'll be another video on how to do pressing moxa and how to use moxa cloth, so watch that one too. Okay, bye.